Today, I would like to present the built-in model libraries. In the Structural Model tab, if I select Load from Library, I have five different libraries from which I can pick a model. A PK library, a PD library, a joint PK-PD, a target mediated drug disposition, and a time-to-event library. Let's have a look at the PK library first. I have a list of models, and on the left side, I can see the parameter names. If I leave the mouse on the file name, I can see a short description of the model. I can directly pick from this list, but it is more convenient to use the filters at the top. I will, for instance, select oral extravascular for the administration, no delay, first order for the absorption, one compartment for the distribution, and linear for the elimination. I end up with two models only, which correspond to different parameterization with either macro or micro constants. If I select a model and go back to the Structural Model tab, I can see the content of the model file. The input parameters, the PK model macro that defines the model, and the output. In the PK library, we have added two additional options compared to the previous version, the transit compartments to create a smooth delay, and the administration of both extravascular and intravascular doses. For such a model, I can see that I must have a column administration ID in the dataset, and that IV doses must be tagged with ID equals 1, and extravascular doses with ID equals 2. For the PKPD library, I have the same options as in the PK library, plus the PD part. I can choose a turnover, effect compartment, or direct model with Emax or Imax drug action. For Imax, I would also be able to choose between full or partial inhibition and with or without sigmoidicity. If I choose a model, I see that I now have two outputs, the concentration CC and the effect E. For those models, the dataset requires an observation ID column, and the first output, the concentration CC, will be mapped to the data with the lowest observation ID value, usually observation ID equals 1. You can find more information about the libraries in the online Monoix documentation in Data and Models, Creating and Using Models, Library of Models. Here we have details about each library, and for the TMDD and time-to-event library, we even have modeling guidelines that you can access via those links. Have a good day and see you next week.